Lord, we just bless you, and we thank you for your name. It's Christ, the Anointed One. We thank you, Father, for your sending your Son. We thank you for the Holy Spirit today, in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, Corinthians, 1 Corinthians 3:9 says, it's for we are. That means right now, God's fellow workers. You are God's field, God's building. And I'm reading out of Richard's Bible. It's highlighted over here. He's got a little micro preach from 5 to 6. But he ends it over there where it says, fellow workers, you are God's field. So I'm just going to start right there. And thank you for the anointing. My mandate, number one, to Zion, the church, is to call this thing of called the Tabernacle of David back into the church. Amen?
Amen.
Restore it. Restore the worship. I still wanted to hand you guys instruments. Well, I did that song, but another time, amen? I did that for many years. You know, it's really the Jewish thing, you know, and we're spiritual Jews, right?
That's right.
Yeah, so we've been grafted in. And Jesus was a Arab? No.
Yeah.
Yeah. Here's the test. Today, this is straight from what I'm writing here. Today, some might be saying, Bible, God wants to restore the Tabernacle of David. We don't need another building project. Amen?
Right.
But, and isn't Christian... Christianity isn't about a literal building anyhow. But it is, amen? And so I'm gonna take you into Acts 15, 16 if you want to go look at that, because there's a literal right there. And I don't know if I shared on this, but Kevin J. Conner gave me permission. Your pastors are connected. And I call you Pastor too, Donna. Under Dick Iverson. Dick Iverson's brother's widow happens to be our good friend. So we didn't know that all the years. We haven't come here, and then they're like, we're sitting there talking, and I'm like, what is going on here, Lord Jesus? You know? We just talked to her. Charlotte is one of the original members of Kevin J. Conner's Tabernacle of David. And she's our good friend, and she called him last night, but we were trying to sleep. And so... We're blessed that way that we have that anointing from that. But Kevin J. Conner gave me permission to do a prophetic excerpt book because I'd already, my wife is responsible for all this except for the mandate came before that. But she brought me his book and it's really deep. If you've ever read any of Kevin's books, they're like, get you a big 3 or 4 different kind of shovels and a pickaxe and the water and everything. You know, you got to really look at what he's writing. Then he's got a little bit of New Zealand in there too. Wherever he's from Australia, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I thought it was New Zealand, but I remember him emailing me from Sydney. With no questions asked, that man said to me, when I asked him permission, he said, Can I teach from your book? And he said, go ahead. So I taught on internet radio, and then I did it in a home meeting. Not home meeting, but at a local meeting in our town. And then I was a long time on, about 6 months actually, that's not long, but on internet radio, and I'm like, Lord, I got a lot of teachings written here, prophetic excerpts on this book. I said, can I write a book of prophetic excerpts? And God goes, yes. So the same way Kevin gave me permission to just teach from it and share a little bit on the internet, I dialed him up on the internet. He says, I said, can I, who says I can write a book based on your book? I said, can I do that? He goes, yeah. So here I am. So my prayer is for you. Please pray for us because I've been through 6 edits of the book. And we're on our last one. We got 10 chapters. So pray for us because I think it's really going to be one of those things where it says, they were the ones that came to turn the world upside down. I won't go into prophetic speak about that, but some of us sometimes we need that upside down thing. Like I like what you said. Your mulukawis, they need to get grilled up, amen. Fertilizer. That's what they call it.
It works.
Well, you know, if you just throw it out back, what good is it? Put it by the plants.
Yeah.
Come on. Just don't preach that, John. Anyhow, there are absolutely definitive scriptural foundations why Christ's church is to restore David's tabernacle. It would be blatant disobedience, and I'm going to say that literally, because when we're going to read that scripture, it would be blatant disobedience for believers in Christ to totally disregard God's decree through the apostle in Acts 15:16. And if you look at it, here's what it says, Acts 15:16. After these things, I will return. That's number one. And I think he's already done that, but not in the, fullness of time when he's here and brand new everything. Amen. And we're glowing. he says, I will return and will build again. Well, who is he going to use to do that? He's going to use us. Amen? He's going to build again the tabernacle of David. What is that, Tom? It's the worship sanctuary. It says tabernacle of David. Does anybody see that? Which has fallen.
God knows.
It's already fallen. He knows. When the book of Acts was written, he caused them to write, caused James to say, tell them it's already fallen, dude. It's in a mess. And we're getting there. I believe we're getting what a profound book Kevin put together. When I asked him, I said, can I do this? He goes, yes, get this message out there. And I was like, I was weeping, man. I was just like, I won't even go there. But it was just so precious to have him just say, go. I'm like, the message needs to get out there. I'm like looking at the email and I'm going, what did you just say? Oh man, that's like, from a man who's written something like 300 books from my scanning on Facebook, I'm like, whoa, I'm struggling with writing one book that's a prophetic answer, not his, but I know it's a mandate given to me from God because it was a vision given to me at 20th Hawthorne in Portland, at Portland's revival. It's a little church there by the Wyatts. I don't know if anybody's ever heard of them. But the Wyatts had a major Bible college in Portland years ago. The biggest Bible college in Portland was owned by the Wyatts. No longer, they're down in Montgomery Village in the area. So I go on to say this is a wonderful passage of scripture in 1 Corinthians 3:9, which speaks about that building. The calls the saints of God, the building of God, also in this portion of scripture, God's word mentions, we labor with God that we are the crop of his field. I love that right there. I must have got that out of Aramaic. We are the crop. Come on. You've been picked.
Amen.
I mean, if he hasn't picked you, oh my, I don't want to go there. He's already picked you. But I think there's a picking, as in, the reason I said that is, there's a point in time, like, Kairos time of God. Kairos is just 59, if you will, in the 59 minutes in an hour, or how many days in a year?
365.
So you got 364 days that are not the Kairos, but maybe 365 is the day that God wants his lined up on his heart time clock to go, this is the day. I mean, those good old songs are good. When they write that song, it's like, dude, you can sing that song with that guitar and heavy it up and make it, you know what I mean? Like you guys played, Lord, I lift your name. When I first got saved, converted, I sang that in a Lutheran church, so when you played that a couple weeks ago, I was like, yeah. I mean, I haven't played that, and I was given some little beats that were fun to it. Amen?
Yeah.
They're old songs, man. Look what I did here. I took a... Well, that's a really old song. I took a psalm, and I turned it into a...
That's
right. Pure, defiled. Amen? Pure, pure, undefiled. Hold that from the tip. That's what God's looking. Come on. Must be a new water or something. might be devil. Yeah, pure, undefiled religion. Amen? Oh, now you were talking about the building, and I just shared this in a home meeting. I do a meeting called Worship Warriors, and these drummers, they invited me. I'm praying for them. Check this out. The Holy Bible is our mortar for the continued building. That we already are in Christ. See, you're talking about that. We're already in Him. Amen. So the Bible is our mortar. Amen. For the continued, continued, I should put internal in there. Well, I said internal working, eternal in us. So this is our mortar. This is our stabilizer to keep us together. Amen?
Yeah.
God's doctrine and Christ are the building blocks we stack up against opposition. Amen? This is what we build upon and work out our own salvation with. Wow. The building blocks. Amen? Not baby building blocks. This is, you guys are dancing around the name of our ministry, Holy Anointed. You're going, holy, holy. And you spell it out, you go, W-H-O-L-E. I'm like, I'm having a little drink up here, so I'm a little bit stammering here. But that was my wife that came up with our oil name. And it was nice to find a bottle of that in the residence we stayed in last night. Thank you, Lord. We're looking for towels. To find an empty bottle of your oil on your brother's shelf. Somebody was using that oil.
Amen.
Come on. We've already been given. Come on. Here's the salvation. I will skip past this. Our life. Hidden in Christ is a garden of precious fruits. Here we go.
Fruits.
Come on, and vegetables. I do not have that either. Precious fruits. I feel like I'm preaching. I'm going to go somewhere over here. Precious fruits and vegetables.
Vegetables.
That will sustain our life. Garden. Our life. His life in us. The precious garden life. For Christ is eternal, therefore. So much more than a natural gardener, even though I love my garden. Christ is the supernatural gardener that encourages us to water our life and the lives of others. It is truly by God's eternal living waters and God's word that we are washed, cleansed, and sanctified. Let me say that again. It's truly by God's eternal living waters. His word, amen? But the living word, too, is Christ. That we're washed, cleansed, and sanctified. That is what believers are to appropriate and participate in. That brings godly renewing of the mind, transformation, and actually translates us. We've all heard this before, glory to glory. So how do we get translated from glory to glory? By the Word. The Word transforms us. Translates us, if you will. And I want to just stop for a second and just say, the Lord has been speaking to me about garments. And I think mindsets are a form of a garment sometimes. Amen?
Amen. Yes.
And so, I don't know how to get away from that. I want to embellish that. What you said, something about dancing in the streets. You know, my pants are a little too long to dance, actually. But I was dancing.
Yes.
And you know, I love your excitement. You just turned 49. And I think it's great, you know, because I speak to people sometimes about the Lord, and I'm like, how come they're not so excited, Lord? Well, let's just take a look up at the ceiling for a second. Now, remember the Bible, they said they blew the hole out of there just to lower in the guy? Let's bypass that and say, okay, Lord, lift the roof off this building, because I know you talked about a building project years ago. And I don't think that's over. I think that's happening someday, Frank. But imagine the roof isn't here.
Come on.
Amen.